We need a place of our own. None of the old mother-in-law bit for me. You'll have your own kitchen if it kills me.
Oh, with my cooking, it probably will.
We'll rent a flat.
Well, that's money down the drain for a start, John. Yeah, I've just had a thought. Why don't we buy a house?
Buy one?
Yes, get a mortgage. Don't you think it's a good idea?
Who do you think I am? Rod Laver? No danger. There are lots of people think like him, you know. They think it's only some well-loaded exclusive minority who own their own homes. Just like him. Whereas nearly half the houses in the country are owned by the people who live in them. In 1970, a quarter of all the mortgages went to people earning under £25 a week. And one in five went to kids like this in their early 20s. They didn't know that, did you? Well, stick around. I'll put a little gems like that when you get to know me. Oh. I wonder if he's any better at ping pong.
There must be some way around it. Go on, you're clever. Think of something else we can do.
Now, the only place where we could get money together like that is from the building society.
Oh, that's a good idea.
No, no, my dad warned me about it. Profit, that's all they're interested in. Squeeze us dry.
Oh, God, there's no point in that.
Oh, he's got a lot to learn, that lad. I mean, nobody owns a building society and profit doesn't come into it. Any small profit there is ploughed back. Which is one good reason why building societies are such a safe place to put your money. Oh, no. Well, the best way to describe a building society is a sort of exchange where blokes like my lad over there, who need money to buy a place, can meet with people with a bit to spare. People with savings who want to earn some interest on it. And it's a pretty good arrangement when you come to think of it. Although the lenders and the borrowers never actually meet, they both benefit. And it's this mutual satisfaction that building societies are all about. Not bad. Now, you remember the Browns? You know, that nice couple with dreams of far-off places. But if they're going to see a bit of the world, they need to get some money together. And I reckon a bit of good old-fashioned saving is their best bet.
Well, if we're going to save, we might as well do it properly.
That's a sensible fella.
What we want is a simple, profitable way, with no risks. None of your brother's stock market tips again.
What about premium bonds?
She must be joking.
Well, we've got 10 each already. Buying a few more won't help. If we win, we win.
Building society?
That's my girl. Now we're getting to it.
They deal in thousands. They're not interested in our sort of money.
Off we go again. Isn't that a young Johnny, is it?
You know, in 1970, there were nearly 10 million people saving to the building societies. And that's not chicken feed when they all put a couple of quid a week in. And lots of people put more. Well, the limit goes up to £10,000. So if you got that much lying about in an old teapot or something, you know what to do with it. Yeah, you can open an account. Easy as winking. And it starts building interest the day it goes in. Yeah, and what's more, it's as safe as houses. Sorry about that.
Oh, I refuse to live with your parents. How much do you think a house will cost?
No, it could be anything, thousands. I haven't got that kind of money. Take me 20 years to get the deposit together.
Blimey, what's he after? Yeah. Booking in Paris. I mean, for a house costing £4,000, he needs £400 for the deposit, another £100 for all the extras, legal costs, evaluation and that. I mean, even if they haven't got a little nest egg, which I'm sure they have got, they're both working with good jobs. So it shouldn't take them long to raise that much.
But we do want quite a large place. I mean, I want sort of somewhere to put children and things when we have them.
A few rooms and a bit of space. We don't want a mock Tudor semi.
What's wrong with a mock Tudor semi? I was born in a mock Tudor semi and they're very nice.
There's nothing wrong with a mock Tudor semi. It's just I want something different, that's all.
What about a nice, lovely, large, modern maisonette?
No, what we want is an old house. Something that we can do something with. And the building societies won't look at them.
Why not?
They just won't touch old property.
Why, because the ceiling's fallen.
Yeah, why, because they're...
He's wrong again. Because one in every six mortgages arranged for pre-1919 houses. And providing they're structurally sound, there's usually no problem.
What's more, in certain cases, you can get grants from the local council to help with renovations. What more does he want? Cat money?
And anyway, what we've saved will be all we've got in case of emergencies. We can't afford to have it all tied up if we need it.
Oh, sorry about that, I missed it. What's he say?
I want to be able to put my hands on my money when I need it. Now, in a bank...
A bank? A bank will charge you for handling his money. But for the building society, there are no charges. And his money's earning interest every day. It's there. And they pay his taxes. So that everything he gets back is his.
And if he does want to get his money in a hurry, he can get, say, up to £100 over the counter. And the rest he can get very quickly.
Tell him, somebody.
Please!
And anyway, which one do we choose? I mean, there are so many building societies, you don't know which way to turn. I mean, how do you know?
Thank you very much. Good morning.